Good morning, children. Welcome back to the channel Awesome Learning. And as you have seen the introduction of the chapter in the previous video, you have learned what is matter. You have also learned if matter is divided into smallest particles, smaller particles. So the smallest particle that we will get is atom, which is further cannot be divided, right? So I also told you in that video that a few laws of chemical combinations were given by Lavoisier, and in this year, that is in class 9th, you are going to study about only two laws. There were further more laws, but in class 9th only two laws are here. Number one is that we are going to learn about is the law of conservation of mass, and the second law is law of constant or definite proportions, right? So first we are going to start with law of conservation of mass. So in your NCERT book there is an activity which is used to explain about the law of conservation of mass. Let's see that activity first. We require measuring cylinders, barium chloride solution, sodium sulfate solution, conical flask, cork, 10 ml test tube, and electronic balance or weighing balance. Measure 5 ml of sodium sulfate solution in measuring cylinder. This is 5 ml. Pour it into the conical flask. Measure 5 ml of barium chloride solution in another measuring cylinder. And pour it into 10 ml test tube. Tie the test tube with the thread and hang the test tube in the conical flask carefully so that the solutions do not mix with each other. Cork the conical flask. Holding the test tube is held firmly. Now let me tell you one thing here. Let me just take you a little bit back and let me show you that, children, this is our conical flask, right? And in this flask we have poured a solution. 5 ml solution, okay, and we have also taken another solution and we have put that solution in the test tube. That means both the solutions are not in contact with each other, and we have also closed the mouth of the conical flask with a cork, but we have used the thread in such a manner that this test tube does not fall, because if it will fall, the two solutions will mix, right? So this was the setup that we have done. Now take the conical flask and carefully weigh the flask on an electronic balance with all the contents, ensuring that the solutions. Now children, let me tell you, I have what all things do I have? I have a conical flask, and in that conical flask there is 5 ml solution. Then I have a test tube, it is also having some solution. I even have a thread, I have a cork. So this whole setup is weighed. This whole setup is weighed. Of course, empty hai. This place is empty, so ye khali nahi hogi. Yahan pe hogi hawa, air. So that will also have some weight. So everything has been weighed here. And what is the weight? I am getting 150.2137 grams. This is the weight of the whole setup. Okay, and what we have to ensure here, we have to ensure that the solutions do not mix with each other. You see what they say? They say that the weighing flask or the electronic balance with all the contents, and ensure that the solutions do not, you see, mix. and note the reading. Take the flask from the balance and tilt it. Now you see, when you tilt the flask, what will happen? Whatever the solution was inside the test tube, that will come out, and the two solutions, that is barium chloride and sodium sulfate, both the solutions will mix, right? See, the test tube, it will spill, and the solutions will mix in the flask and form white colored precipitate of barium sulfate and aqueous solution of sodium chloride. See, wait for 10 minutes to complete the reaction. The precipitate of barium chloride will, let me take you a little bit back. It will, what will happen? Okay, so weigh the contents. Wait for 10 minutes. It is moving too fast. Now you have to wait for 10 minutes to complete the reaction. The precipitate of barium sulfate will settle down. Now what is precipitate, children? Precipitate is thick mass. ठीक है? Paste जैसी चीज बन जाएगी. So barium sulfate will form a precipitate. It will be paste-like, and because it is paste-like, so it is heavy, so it will settle down. And what will happen? You see, at the bottom of the flask. Now you weigh the flask again. Now what you see is, note down the reading. What is the reading that you are getting? Okay, see the reading that you are getting here. It is 150.2137 grams, right? And this was the same reading that we had taken before the reaction took place, right? So what does it mean? See, let me show you here. Now you see, mass of total apparatus plus mass of reactants. Children, reaction से पहले जो भी चीजें हैं, they are called reactants, and after the reaction, whatever we get is called product. So here, total mass of the apparatus is same here also, and total mass of the apparatus, क्योंकि apparatus थोड़ी change हुआ है, apparatus तो वही है, वही conical flask है, वही test tube है, वही thread है, वही cork है. So apparatus is same in both the cases, before the reaction, after the reaction. But here, before the reaction, mass of the reactants was m plus m1, that is how much? 150.2137. total, sabka total agar karein, this is what I am getting, the mass. After the reaction, you see, after the reaction has been done, again the mass is same. Why? Reaction se pehle bhi wahi mass, reaction ke baad bhi wahi mass. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? What is the conclusion that we are getting? Since m remains constant and m1 is equal to m2, that is total mass of the reactants is equal to total mass of the product, है ना? Total mass of the reactant, क्योंकि apparatus का mass तो change नहीं होगा, यहाँ पे भी capital M है, यहाँ पे भी capital M है, और m1 है before reaction, m2 है after reaction. And m1 is equal to m2. So that means what? This says, law of conservation of mass says that mass of the reactants is always equal to mass of the products. ठीक है, product कुछ भी हो, but total mass remains the same. Okay, so this means, this also means, children, that matter cannot be created nor it can be destroyed. क्यों? आप ये चीज देखो, अगर यहां पर मास कुछ और होता, ठीक है, मान लो कि रिएक्शन से पहले मास है 150.2137, लेकिन रिएक्शन के बाद सपोज मास है ओनली 150, ये 2137 नहीं है, तो आप ये पूछोगे ना कि मैम, ये जो मास नहीं है प्रोडक्ट्स में, जो मास कम हो गया, तो ये कहाँ चला गया? कहीं तो गया, या तो गैस बन के उड़ गया या कहीं यूज हो गया, कहीं तो जाना चाहिए। ऐसा तो है नहीं कि 150.2137 था पहले और अब जो है वो 150 रह गया, तो ये जो पोर्शन है, ये जो मास है, ये कहाँ चला गया? इसका रीजन एक ही है बच्चों, द रीजन इज मैटर कैन नॉट बी क्रिएटेड नॉर इट कैन बी डिस्ट्रॉयड। ठीक है, ना हम मैटर को क्रिएट कर सकते हैं, ना हम मैटर को डिस्ट्रॉय कर सकते हैं। वी कैन ओनली कन्वर्ट द मैटर फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म टू अनदर। सपोज अनदर एग्जाम्पल आई टेक, सपोज आई हैव टेकन 2 grams ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड 1 gram ऑफ वाटर हाइड्रोजन, 2 gram ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड 1 gram ऑफ हाइड्रोजन। ओके, सो इफ दे कंबाइन टूगेदर वॉट इज द टोटल मास? 2 gram ऑक्सीजन एंड 1 gram हाइड्रोजन, तो टोटल मास क्या है? आप कहोगे टोटल मास ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट इज 3 gram। Now if I ask you कि भैया oxygen and hydrogen को react करा दो, so when they get reacted they form water, right? तो water जब बना तो water का mass क्या होगा जो बना? That is again 3 gram। क्योंकि अगर 3 gram नहीं है, suppose आप बनाते हो water and you say कि मेरे water का weight तो आ रहा है 2 gram, तो मैं आपसे पूछूंगी ना कि 1 gram कहाँ गया? I gave you 3 grams, मैंने आपको सामान दिया, मैंने आपको बोला पुलाव बनाओ, राइट? मैंने आपको 1 किलो चावल दिए, आधा किलो मटर दिए, प्याज दिया, सब कुछ दिया सामान, और मैंने सब कुछ वेट करके दिया। मैंने बोला टोटल इन सब का वेट जो है, पुलाव बनाने का जो सामान है उसका टोटल वेट है सपोज 10 किलो। ठीक है, अब आफ्टर मेकिंग द पुलाव, आफ्टर मेकिंग द पुलाव मैं उसको वेट करती हूँ तो 8 किलो आ रहा है, तो मैं आपसे पूछूंगी नहीं कि भैया 2 किलो कहाँ गया? कहीं तो हुआ, कहीं तो गया। तो आप कहोगे हवा हो गया है, हवा तो नहीं हो सकता ना, क्या मैं आपकी बात मान जाऊंगी? अगर हवा भी हुआ तो हवा में गैस बन के उड़ा तो वो कैसे, मतलब दैट इज ऑल्सो काउंटेड। पर इस केस में हमने तो कोनिकल फ्लास्क को ऊपर से बंद कर दिया, तो अगर गैस भी उड़ रही है तो वो कहीं बाहर तो जा ही नहीं सकती, यानी एवरीथिंग इज हियर इनसाइड। तो गैस भी अगर बनी है तो उसका वेट भी तो आएगा ना हमारे पास। अंडरस्टूड? सो रिमेंबर चिल्ड्रन, मैटर कैन नॉट बी क्रिएटेड नॉर इट कैन बी डिस्ट्रॉयड। हाँ, इट कैन चेंज इट्स स्टेट, इट कैन चेंज फ्रॉम सॉलिड टू लिक्विड और फ्रॉम लिक्विड टू गैस और फ्रॉम गैस टू लिक्विड, बट यू कैनॉट से कि इट हैज सडनली डिस्ट्रॉयड और आई कैन क्रिएट अ मैटर, दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल। वी कैनॉट क्रिएट मैटर, वी कैनॉट डिस्ट्रॉय अ मैटर, वी कैन ओनली चेंज इट्स स्टेट। ओके, इफ आई गिव यू अ ग्लास ऑफ वॉटर एंड आई आस्क यू टू यूटिलाइज दिस वॉटर एंड मेक इट आइस, one glass of water, so each and every molecule of that water will get converted into ice. अगर आपने suppose आधा पानी evaporate करा दिया, तो I will ask ना कहाँ गया वो पानी? आपने आधे पानी की ice बनाई, बाकी का आधा पानी कहाँ चला गया? तो बाकी का आधा पानी कहाँ चला गया? It converted into water vapor, that is gas, but वो destroy नहीं हुआ, it got converted, it did not get destroyed. So remember, law of conservation of mass isi theory pe based hai. Law of conservation of mass says that matter cannot be created nor it can be destroyed, hence the mass of the reactants will always be equal to the mass of the products. I hope this experiment is clear to all of you.